In this tutorial video, we will explain how to prioritize analysis results and how to deal with the messages that you get. The first thing that you will notice is that we have the severity filter. You can have level 0 or 1 to 9 severity levels, and this is the first approach that one can take to deal with the issues that are found. First, ask yourself a few questions. Am I doing general analysis against a particular internal standard? Do I have an internal company standard, a corporate standard, or an industry standard? Those standards tend to be the place that you need to start with to determine how to prioritize things. We provide a severity filter. So if there are things that, from a general industry good practice perspective, allow you to start in with some initial results. However, if you're doing CertC, MISRA, CWE, High Integrity C++, or any of the other standards, these severity levels are sort of independent of each of those standards. Without respect to other facts, they tend to be the messages in isolation and are sort of determined by what the severity is for that particular issue. However, in a different instance, a low severity item may be part of a high priority rule because it's part of the enforcement for that rule. Next, let's take a look at something that has internal linkage. Here, we can see incompatible declarations, which is something that you'll want to look at. There are two different locations to look at those. The first place is, what are your requirements for standards? We'll go through a couple of the standards here and discuss that. We'll start with CWE, and then jump over to the Common Weakness Enumeration page on their website. You can see that CWE, which is maintained by the MITRE Corporation, has things to do with software, hardware, research concepts, and other criteria. They're keeping track of a lot of different weaknesses that are found. A part of that is software weaknesses, which include a lot of subcategories, undefined behaviors, authentication errors, and things that people can deal with respect to that. A certain percentage of these can be found through static analysis, while others cannot. Let's look at the CWE Top 25, which are typically able to be found through static analysis. You can see right out of the box that the top level thing is out of bounds rights. So we'll write off the end of an array, using a pointer that goes to a place it's not expected. And then there are out of bound reads. Each of these has a designation with numbers that discuss what this particular issue is. But for our example, there's no particular priority. If you're interested in the top 25, you can make that part of your standard, but it's up to you what you want to include. Now, if you go into the Helix QAC tools, you can go to the project properties and configure this for CWE. You will then see that we've got some common messages for syntax errors and the weakness listed. Here, we have subcategorized things into several categories and compound elements. In general, what you're looking for is the CWE number, the particular rules, and the messages that enforce it. So we need to decide what is the priority in terms of the things that you're looking for. You can certainly look for everything that's in here, but if you want just the top 25, you can isolate them and disable the ones you don't want. So for CWE, it's more up to you how to prioritize the interests, the messages, and the rules of interest. Next, let's look at CertC, which has its own set of criteria. Carnegie Mellon is the powerhouse behind setting up these coding security requirements. This includes rules, which must be met in terms of the criteria, and recommendations, which are suggestions for improving code quality. You can see that there's a three-letter designator and numbers that go with them for memory management, integers, containers, and concurrency. If you drill down another level, you will see that you get one of those three-letter acronyms, a bunch of numbers, and a description. You can also see down here that for each category of issues, there is a severity, a likelihood, and a remediation cost. There's a formula for that, which we'll show you in a second, that results in a priority and a level, and you can see that these numbers are taken together to generate this overall severity or priority. When you run CertC, you will see that there are a set of rules, with each processing its own unique three-letter designations. For all the rules, you can disable the recommendations. But even within this, if you look at the individual priorities, you can look through and identify which are the highest value from the CertC perspective. you can enable and disable these priorities to focus on a particular one, rather than having to address them all at the same time. Next, let's look at MISRAC and MISRAC++ and AutoSAR. As you can see, there are mandatory, required, and advisory, as well as some extra categorizations because of targeting specific languages. But for C and C++, there's required, advisory, and document. Required corresponds to mandatory, advisory to required, and document to advisory. In this case, you're going to be looking at the mandatory requirements. These are the ones that you need to focus on first. If you're looking at actual results, then you would want to select all of the results. Go to your rule groups and start looking at the mandatory issues first. You want to review those particular issues first. For MISRA, we suggest you review mandatory required and then advisory. Reset the filter, and that would be the approach. You would do the same thing for MISRA C++. For AutoSAR, you can disable these rule messages. Or, once again, over here in the rules groups, you can focus strictly on the requirements by showing only them first, or more specifically, a particular rule if that's what you're trying to do. The takeaway that we'd like to leave you with is that for any particular coding standard, it has its own internal prioritization mechanism, and that things like the severity filter here can be used in addition to that, to sort of focus things on a daily basis. But usually the standard itself is the basis for determining how to prioritize the messages that you need to work on from day to day. For more information on how to get the most out of your static analysis tool, visit our library of guided tutorial videos.